What's going on, YouTube? I'm your boy KP, and in today's video we're going to talk about pause reps. Are you doing pause reps? If not, I think you're making a big mistake. So first, let's start off by saying or answering the question of what is a pause rep. A pause rep, to me, in my opinion, is basically when you take the momentum out of the lift, you take the stretch reflex out of the lift. So let's use bench press for example. The pause rep would be bring the bar down to your chest, pause for a quick second, pause long enough for you to, you know, be sure that the momentum has been eliminated from the lift. That's basically what a pause rep is. So what a pause rep does is it allows momentum to be eliminated, like I said before, and it allows the stretch reflex to dissipate, right? So let's take the bench press, for example, again. When you're lowering the bar down to your chest, you're stretching the muscles out, right? And your muscles have what's called a stretch reflex. When they're stretched out, the reflex of the muscle is going to be for it to contract back to its regular size, okay? And what that does is when you stretch the muscle out, it becomes filled with energy. So let's just use a rubber band for example. You take a rubber band just dangling, it has no energy in it, right? It's loose. So when you stretch it out, that's when you energize the rubber band, okay? So when you let it go, the energy that you created by stretching it out allows it to contract and come back to its normal size. So when you're bench pressing or you're doing any other movement and you want to take the stretch reflex away or the momentum away, you just basically pause and you allow for that energy that's created and stored in the muscle to go away. So the only option that you have is for the muscle itself, you know, and not momentum, not the stretch reflex, to be able to, or to have to generate enough force to get that weight back moving again. Now, momentum is okay. Like, you can use momentum on certain lifts. You can use momentum in the squat to help you bounce yourself out of the hole. You can use it on a bench. You can use it doing dumbbell presses for shoulders. You can use it doing rows. Like, you can use pause reps on anything. In my opinion, the pause rep is the true indicator of strength, because you have to be a strong son of a gun to bring 405 pounds down to your chest, rest it there for a second, and then explode it back up. Now, the bigger your muscles are, the more force your muscles are going to be able to produce. So that's why you see, especially in powerlifting competitions, on the bench press, they'll have the command to bring it down. They don't have to pause it for a quick second to take that momentum out, right? To eliminate the stretch reflex on that exercise. So from that point on, the only thing that's going to get that weight back moving again is going to be raw strength. Okay, now if I had the opportunity to go back to when I first started lifting and give my younger self one piece of advice, it would be to do pause reps on as many exercises as I possibly could, because I credit pause reps for the strength that I currently have on the bench press. My bench press didn't go up until I started to implement pause reps into my routine, and, you know, alongside touch and go. You can use your touch and go reps to, you know, build muscle that's still going to be time under tension. So touch and go is still an effective way to, you know, build muscle and to build strength as well. But when you talk about raw power, raw strength, nothing beats a pause rep. Okay, so when you go to implement the pause rep into your routine, you just use the same type of progression that you would use on touch and go reps. So let's just say, let's use the bench press for example again. If your rep range is 3 to 5, which I recommend when you're focusing on strength and size, really, but we're just going to use strength in this example. So when you use 3 to 5 reps and you're focusing on strength, you would, let's say you're doing 225 pounds and you can only get 3 pause reps, okay? You would continue to use 225 pounds until you can do it for 5 pause reps. And then once you get to that top, the ceiling for your reps, which in this case is going to be 5, you add 5 pounds and you start all over again. So I believe that everybody should do pause reps. Everybody can benefit from an increase in just raw, pure strength. Strength is something that translates over into every other aspect of life. Okay? So the next time you're in the gym, try pause reps, because those are going to keep you honest in the gym. And what I mean by keep you honest in the gym is, if you're bench pressing and you normally do 225 pounds for, let's just say, 5 touch and go reps, you're not going to be able to start off using 225 pounds for pause reps. You're going to have to, you know, you have to check the ego at the door and you have to lower the weight. And pause reps can be an excellent way to bust through a plateau if you just regularly use touch and go reps. Okay, now I know I'm ranting on, but you know, this is some advice I know you guys could use, so you know, I'm going to give it to you. Let's just say you hit a plateau at 275 pounds. You can only get 275 pounds for 5 touch and go reps. What you could do, and what I've done in the past, and what I will continue to do, is take off about, let's go from 275 pounds down to about 250, and then focus on pause reps, sets of 5. When you are able to work your way up using pause reps to 275 pounds for 5 reps, you will have bust through that plateau. Trust me, because you're stimulating your chest in a different way and you developed a lot more power than you had before. So when you go back to doing touch and go reps, you will be somewhere maybe 280, 285, I don't know. But you will be able to do more weight than just 275 pounds. So if you're not using pause reps, try pausing your reps in your next workout. Come back and tell me how that worked out for you. Okay, this is KP. I hope you found this information informative. I hope it'll help you out in some way. It's helped me out a lot in the past years. And happy lifting, man. Remember, lift heavy, lift often, and lift smart. This is KP, Full Body Assault. We out.